Hello gamers, today I decided to create my very first 2D game using Unity tilemaps. I've never used tilemaps before, so it's gonna be a lot of learning. This time I'm gonna be creating a game that everyone have played, at least everyone knows it. It's a Bomberman, the game where player has to put bombs on the map and the bomb destroys the destructible objects as well as kill enemies. So it's gonna be a lot of fun, it's gonna be a lot of learning. Also gonna be try and implement enemy movement without using any kind of pathfinding system, so that's gonna be fun. So let's go. First, I downloaded this 2D character astronaut pack, which is free. I'll leave the link down below. It has some great tilemap textures, lot of animations, which I don't need. I just need the idle walk, death, and bomb. I started with creating a grid system and a tilemap in Unity. I did not know anything about creating grid-based 2D game or tilemap game in Unity, so I didn't know how the movement works with the tilemap, how to spawn objects on the grid, and nothing. So I went straight to the YouTube. There was this tutorial for the Bomberman from Brekkies. So I followed it until I got the spawning bombs right. I decided to create a 15x10 tilemap for play area. So I added background layer all over the screen and surrounded the 15x10 play area with the walls, which was on different layer of the tilemap so that our player can collide with the walls only. I added tilemap collider to the walls layer, then rigid body and a composite collider to optimize. For player, I added a sprite with the player graphics and added collider and rigid body. My idea here is to spawn non-destructible tiles on alternate grid with keeping other empty space for destructible tiles. Then spawning the destructible tiles on the alternate empty space and keeping some of the remaining grids empty. I created a game object for spawning tiles, then created a simple script for spawning. I just instantiated the object from array with the random index, created three different prefabs for non-destructible, destructible, and empty game objects. In the array of game objects, I added these three created prefabs in a way that if the number of specific objects is higher, then more likely the object will spawn. So that's how there is more possibility of spawning the empty tile on the given position. I duplicated the same game object spawner a couple of times to fill the playable area with it. I deleted destructible and non-destructible game objects from the spawners around the player, so player would have enough space to move around and place bombs. Then I selected alternate spawners and removed the empty and destructible tiles from the list while only keeping the non-destructible objects. And for other spawners, I kept the destructibles but removed non-destructibles. For the player movement, I used rigid body, added force to it, and used the old input system here. For the bomb explosion, I already had animations and graphics included in the asset pack, so I used those. I created a game object for spawning the bomb, created a new script. To spawn bomb exactly on the center of the tile cell, I wrote this small script where tilemap.worldToCenter is an inbuilt function used for getting the exact cell square from the given tilemap. It has reference to the player position, which means wherever the player moves, it gets the nearest cell. Tilemap.getCellCenterWorld is another function to get the center point of the nearest tilemap, which takes cell we created earlier as a reference. Then I simply instantiated the bomb on the center of the cell. For exploding, I created another script on the bomb, spawn explosion after 3 seconds and destroyed the current object, which is bomb. So this will work if I want to explode only the cell which contains the bomb, not the other cells around. To explode the cells around, I just created these two functions, explode block, which will see if there are any obstacles like non-destructible tiles or wall to prevent explosion going beyond the nearest wall. Then there is an explode function, which takes a vector to position, which is bomb's position. This function will actually spawn explosion on the empty and destructible tiles around the bomb. I changed the sprites for destructibles from these barrels to wood barrier, cause this looks much better and it has animations which looks cool. And I tested it for a couple of times and went to sleep. The next day I went for creating enemies, which was challenging task as I never built an AI before. I came up with the raycasting and then moving the enemy on the empty tile. I created this enemy patrol script and created couple of variables for raycasting. Then in the fixed update method, I emitted 4 rays from enemy to scan in 4 directions. Then created a movement method to randomly select the empty cell and store the value in the get integer value. Then in the update method, I simply set the directions and in the fixed update, I moved the enemy using rigid body velocity. I called the movement function in the invoke repeating to update the directions every 1 second. I wanted the enemies to spawn randomly in the empty cells, so I made simple changes into the spawn tile script. And here it is, the first ever tile map game I made with the first ever enemy patrolling system. Not very good though, not really polished, but it's playable. I have put the link to the game in the description so you can try and download it and play it. From past couple of months, I was a little busy and was up to something. And also, I'm bringing a giveaway for you in upcoming week or two. So don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you won't miss it. Hit the like button if you found this video interesting. I will see you in the next one. Have a good day.